factors by inspection. So we all know what is the meaning of integrating factor. It's used to multiply with a differential equation to make it exact if it is non-exact. So there are different ways of finding integrating factors. Three of them we have already introduced, and there is no new way which we are going to do. It's with the same old way. I'm just going to do one, two more examples, and then we will move to the next case. Okay. So by inspection, I gave you certain formulas, but at the same time, I told you that there is no absolute list of formulas which will cover all the questions. You have to practice it yourself, that what factor you can multiply so that you start seeing a function for which you can write a total differential. Right? So I'm giving you another example for the same. Say you have x divided minus y dx, 2x square minus 3 dx. So firstly, you will very easily be able to check this is not exact. If you take 2x square minus 3 to that side, you find ny and x, they will not be equal. So this is not exact, so now I have to look for integrating factor. So I will start looking for expressions like, I am using the method of inspection. So y dx plus x dy, y dx minus x dy minus y dx, or x dx plus y dy. So we know these are the frequently occurring expressions in these questions. So this is subtraction. So wherever they are coming in subtraction, x dy minus y dx or y dx minus x dy, so it's always with the fraction because you will be using quotient rule. So this gives you the hint ki either it will be x by y or it will be y by x. So you can see that if it is going to be x by y by x, then it is going to be x dy minus y dx by x square. So this gives me the hint that let's try dividing the equation with x square, right? So I'm writing that multiplying 1 by x square. So my 1 by x square is that I'm trying as an integrating factor. So when you multiply this 1 by x square on both sides, on left side you will get this, and on right side you will get this. So on left hand side I can write it is, it is y by x, and on right hand side it's not always possible, or it will not happen in all the examples that on both the sides you will find total differential. But even if you are able to find it on one side, and the other side is just function of one variable. So you see on the right hand side I have just everything with respect to x, and a dx is written over there. So integration is easy. This technique is not going to work, say if I have something like this over this side, plus y. So I cannot integrate with the presence of y over here, right? So this is something you have to see, that y somewhere you have to adjust. So it will automatically happen in these questions, that one side you have to try to make the integrating factor, and the other side it will automatically be easier for you to just integrate. So now you just write the same thing and very easily you can solve. So on integrating you will get y by x is, so this is 2 minus 3 by x square. Yes, because that is 2x square. So now you can integrate 2x minus, what it is going to be, plus 3 by x plus c. So you want to express the final general solution in the form y is equal to a function of x, so you can take x to that side. So it's 2x square plus 3 plus cx. Right? So by inspection, you will figure out, I also told you this point last time, that if you are able to figure out by inspection the integrating factor, it's going to be easier calculation. But still, you have to explore it yourself, which one works best for you. Right? So very quick, one more example of the same type, and then we will go to the next topic. So it's dy plus y by x dx is sin x dx. So what kind of factors we are trying to look at? X dy plus y dx plus x dx plus y dy. So you know, if I multiply this, so this is just a step before finding the integrating factor. Just one thing you need to do. This x you take as LCM or however you want to interpret it. Multiplying with x on both the sides. So now on left hand side I see a factor like x dy plus y dx, right? So in which kind of expressions you will get that d of xy, right? Because it's clear now plus aayega, so division wala nahi hoga because quotient rule division nahi aata hai. So it's plus. So plus mein do tarah ke hote hain. X dx plus y dy hoga. So wo x square plus y square se aata hai. और x dy plus y dx होगा, so that is product of x into y. So on left hand side this is product of x into y, x sin x dx. So you could say that given this form, if I treat that equation in that form, it will appear to me in a non-exact form. But on multiplication with x, it is coming with a directly in a exact form. So this is the exact form, or you can say this x which we multiplied in the beginning is acting as an integrating factor. Ultimately wants to make it exact. Whether you have written that word that this is integrating factor or not, that does not matter. Somehow you have to got the kind of factors in your equation. You got that, and now you can solve this. So upon integrating, so I get this. So you use integration by parts and you will get your answer. So I'm writing that directly. Xy is minus x cos x plus sin x plus c. So y, if you want to write as a general solution, so this is going to be a general solution of this equation. And again, stating the same thing which I have explicitly not stated, but few of you asked me this doubt. Then I told that it's not always unique. The method is not unique. Maybe you figure out, okay, this is becoming variable separable, so I can use variable separable. You are okay to use that. So whichever method you think fits the kind of differential equation, you can always use that. So it just becomes a hierarchy. हम अपने माइंड में एक हायरार्की बना के चलते हैं. बिकॉज अभी क्या हो रहा है, राइट नाउ आई एम टेलिंग यू कि हम एग्जैक्ट के क्वेश्चन कर रहे हैं, तो आपको पता है कि ऐसे ही सोचना है. द मोमेंट अ रैंडम क्वेश्चन कम्स इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू, फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू आर ट्राइंग टू राइट द एग्जाम, सो नोबडी हैज मेंशन देयर कि पहला क्वेश्चन वेरिएबल सेपरेबल का है, दूसरा क्वेश्चन एग्जैक्ट का है. इवन इन ट्यूटोरियल शीट द ऑर्डर इज लाइक दैट, दैट बाय डिफॉल्ट वी टेंड टू थिंक लाइक ओके दिस इज वेरिएबल सेपरेबल, दिस इज होमोजीनियस. So the things are easy. So you have to train your mind in identifying it yourself. Nobody is going to tell you ki ispe variable separable lagega, ki exact wala method lagega. So you devise your own technique. Okay, then firstly quickly I'll just look at variable separable ho raha hai nahi, reducible to variable separable ho raha hai ki nahi. Then try to think, means whichever way you find easier for you, so you will go for that. And this will come with practice. It's not like, it's just like the चैप्टर सीरीज वी हैड, ज्योमेट्रिक सीरीज बन रहा है नहीं बन रहा है, टेलीस्कोपिंग बन रहा है नहीं बन रहा है, सो देयर वाज अ हायरार्की डेवलप देयर एंड इवेंचुअली वी रीच एट द राइट टेस्ट विच इज एप्लीकेबल ऑन दैट सीरीज. सो सेम इज हियर, यू विल नॉट बी टोल्ड दैट दिस इक्वेशन इज ऑफ दिस टाइप, यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई दैट योरसेल्फ. ओके, हैविंग सेड दैट, सो दैट फिनिशेस दिस एग्जैक्ट डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एंड नाउ वी आर मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट टाइप ऑफ differential equation. It's not new, it's just a category into the same kind which we are doing. Linear differential equation of first order. So in the beginning, in the introductory lecture, we talked about these terms, linear, non-linear. I hope the meaning was clear to everybody. We should be just looking for linearity in dependent variable, y, y dash, y double dash, जितने भी order की कोई equation है, उनके product terms नहीं आने चाहिए, उनके square नहीं आने चाहिए, उनके कोई भी powers नहीं आने चाहिए. X के साथ product हो सकता है, x के किसी function के साथ product हो सकता है, sin x, log x, cos x, all that is allowed. Sine y, cos hyperbolic y, that's not allowed. So y may only linearity, but x or x functions may we can have anything. So that is the meaning of linear differential equation. Because when you will be thinking to apply this technique, so you should be clear about whether this is linear or not. And specifically, now we are doing it for first order. इससे पहले हमने जितने भी मेथड्स किए हैं, they were not anywhere mentioning this is for linear or this is for non-linear. They were general techniques, variable separable, homogeneous, exact. But this one is now specifically for linear differential equations of first order. So firstly, you need to get a framework. How does a linear differential equation of first order looks like? Okay. So in general, I told you that these are the terms which you are going to see. Because first order is, so you will be having only derivatives up to y dash. So x will be there, some function of x, y and y dash. So this function will be there. You will have a mathematical expression which will be having a operations between x, y and y dash. So if this f is linear in y, y dash, then the equation, the differential equation is said to be linear differential equation. So just very quickly, I'll just ask you, so you just need to tell me whether that is linear or not. So this one, whether this was linear or not? Linear or non-linear? Just look at the differential equation. It's linear. I told you x, sin x can be present. Sirf aap jab bhi linearity dekho, y or y dash ko dekh lo. Y is there, y dash is there. They are not having any power. They are not multiplied together. Y square nahi hai, y dash square nahi hai, kuch nahi hai. Dy is there, y is there. That's it. So it's a linear differential equation. So you will see eventually when we'll be doing the next technique on the same problem, you can apply that technique also because it falls into the category of linear first order differential equation. Okay. Was this linear? Yes, this was also linear because this y you see as a product, but it's y with x. It's not y dy. It's y with dx. The moment you write it in the form dy by dx, it will automatically appear to you. This is linear. Okay, so let me come to the... So you understood the meaning and the definition. So now I'm going to the algorithm. That how it is going to be look like. So you can always express the linear differential equation in this form. So now we are going to introduce some standard conventional notation, right? Obviously, as you can see, as you have seen in both the examples, original kuch bhi form mein given ho sakta hai, but you can always put that equation in this form, dy by dx plus y ke saath kuch multiply mein hoga, kyunki multiplication mein scalar is allowed and x ka koi bhi function is allowed. So in general, it is denoted by px is equal to right hand side pe you will have purely a function of x. बिकॉज y का कोई फंक्शन अलाउड नहीं है ना, y स्क्वायर y कुछ ऐसा नहीं है. अगर राइट हैंड साइड पे y है तो दैट टर्म कैन बी एडजस्टेड विद दिस वन, क्योंकि y इज ओनली अलाउड, y स्क्वायर इज नॉट अलाउड. सो दिस इज द जनरल फॉर्म ऑफ अ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर लीनियर डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन. एवरीबडी अग्रीज? यू विल डू द क्वेश्चन एंड यू विल सी दैट योर सेल्फ. इट विल ऑटोमेटिकली बी रिप्रेजेंटेड इन दिस फॉर्म वेरी कन्वीनियंटली. If it is not in this form, like the previous question, so we will first convert it to this form, so it's easy to apply the method. Like the same example which we just wrote, dy plus y by x dx is sine x dx. So this dx can be shifted to this side, and then we will see how it can be changed to the linear term. And similarly, the other one. This one also. That term can be shifted to this side, then divided with dx. You can always do that and convert to linear. Yes, is there any doubt? I'm asking these girls. No? Okay. Sorry, no offense. Okay. Yeah. So let's just tell you the method that once you have in this form, it's a standard notation. Different authors use different notation. In some books you will find small p, small q. In some books you will find capital P, capital Q. So just a matter of the notation of the author. So it's going to be a function of x. So this px and qx are going to be the functions of x. Means it is one particular form. It's been given a name. This is called Leibniz form. First order linear differential equation. If it is, you are finding it in this form, so this is called Leibniz form. So now we are trying to know, okay, given an equation of this type, how we are going to find a solution of it. So basically, the technique which we are going to use is the same which we used for exact. So let's first see whether this is exact or not. So treat it as a question. Although I have not given you the value of px and qx, treat it like a differential equation and check whether this is exact or not. If it is not exact, then we will try to find the integrating factor. Okay. So how do you check exactness? For checking exactness, you need to express in this form. Mdx plus ndy is 0, because we know that the condition of exactness is del m by del y should be same as del n by del x. For exactness check, we need to express the same equation in this form. So it's very easy to do. Express this in this form. How you are going to write? Dy pxy dx is qx dx. I just multiplied with dx on both the sides and then get px into y minus qx. This is a common coefficient of dx plus dy is equal to 0. I can give you the direct formula also, but I want you to see how that particular formula is coming. So this is coming from this theory that you treat it, you test it for exactness and then you use the same technique. Is it okay? I expressed in the form mdx plus ndy. So now this is my n. So it's py minus q. I'm writing them pq as such, but we know that they are functions of x. And what is n? N is 1. Right? Because dy's coefficient is 1. So what is m? Derivative, partial derivative with respect to y. Given the information that p and q are functions of x. So although you do not know their functions, but still you can find this my. What is that? Px, right? Because, py. With respect to, just p. Because y derivative with respect to y is going to be 1 and p is, whatever p is, it's a function of purely x. So it will be just multiplied. Q's derivative with respect to y will be 0 because q is just a function of x. So my is just p, means obviously p as a function of x. And what is nx? 0. Right? So n is 1, so its derivative with respect to x is 0. So if this px is 0, suppose p happens to be 0 function, means you just erase this term from your original differential equation, then it is exact. Everybody can see that. It's the easiest differential equation to solve. Dy by dx is qx, just integrate. Right? Agar px hai nahi hai, toh trivially bahut easily solvable hai. So we'll assume ki we are looking for that method when px is non-zero. So you can just add a point here that if px is 0, then dy by dx is qx is exact and solvable, integrable. Just integrate and solve. Right? This kind of differential equation we don't even explicitly introduce because it's very easy. Just given the autonomous sign, so then you can do. So this we will deal with the case when px is non-zero, the non-trivial case. So when px is non-zero, so these two are not equal, so hence the equation is not exact. So since the equation is not exact, then you look for integrating factor. So we'll start with the not the inspection case here, because we cannot use the method of inspection here because we do not know what is p and what is q. I can try the other two cases, the case 1 and case 2 which we discussed. So that was, you take the difference of these two px minus 0 means p minus 0. And if I divide this with n, because you see my n is very simple, just a constant. This is a mixed function of y and q, n. Because I have two options, I can try dividing with n and I can try dividing with m. So if you try with n, so it is just 1. So it is just px only. Px by 1 is px. So this falls into one of the cases, that if the difference between my and nx on dividing with n happens to be a function of purely x, in that case, this is clearly a function of x, we know that. So what is the integrating factor? E raised to power integral of px dx. Right? So this is where our questions start from. So now in every question, we will not do these steps, m and n. Theoretically, we have proved that this is always going to work as integrating factor for the given differential equation, because we have not put any conditions on p and q. Whatever p and q are given to you, this will always work for that kind of differential equation. So that derivation I have shown you. So directly in our questions, we will compute this integrating factor and do the questions. And once you know the integrating factor, so we know what is the solution, of how to find the solution. So you know the shortcut way. So it's y into, okay, let me just even write this one for you. Maybe you do not know this one. Okay, let me tell you how this is also going to come. So now we are trying to find a general solution. So you can use two ways here theoretically. One is, we know that how do we find a general solution of an exact differential equation after multiplication with integrating factor. Another is, you can use the definition of integrating factor. So you multiply this with the given differential equation. So I get e raised to power px dx. This is the form we expressed here in. I'm multiplying this form. Dy plus px into y into e raised to power px dx into dx is equal to, right hand side is qx. Qx into e raised to power px dx dx. So I've just taken the original differential equation and multiplied it with the integrating factor. And now I know it should become exact, because that's what the meaning of integrating factor is. So you can identify on the left hand side, this is basically, if I take this as a function, y into e raised to power integral px dx, then if you open this differential, you use the product rule now, what it will be? First function, derivative of second, plus second function means y as such, derivative of this. What is the derivative of e raised to power integral px? E raised to power integral px, and then derivative of integral px. So derivative integral gets cancelled, it's just px. So that is coming as a product. So you, it's very easy to verify this function. If I take, I use the product rule, I get back this expression. And on right hand side, you don't need to find the total differential, because everything is just a function of x. So if I have this form, so now you just integrate. So when you will be integrating, what you get? Y into e raised to power px dx is integral of completely this one. Qx into e raised to power px dx dx, obviously plus c will automatically be introduced when you integrate. So this is the general solution of the Leibniz form of the linear differential equation of first order. I didn't intend you to do this derivation, but anyways, we did it completely. So you just need to remember this one. In case you don't need to remember, at least you remember the integrating factor, because after integrating factor, we know everybody knows how to find a general solution of after multiplying with the integrating factor. The same technique you can use, which we introduced for exact equations. So this is also remembered easily in this way. Y into integrating factor is integral of q into integrating factor. A dx is q ke liye into integrating factor will be a function. So however you want to remember this, and what is integrating factor? E raised to power px dx. So let me just do questions for the same or type. Okay, so example 1, x dy by dx minus 3y is x raised to power 4. So first thing is, we'll try to express it in the form which we want. What is the form we want? Y dash plus some function of x into y should be equal to some function of x. So x, I can divide with x. So it's dy by dx. On dividing with x, I am getting it into the Leibniz form. So px and qx should be here. So this is my px, this is my qx. Is it clear? What is integrating factor then? Directly you can use e raised to power integral px dx. So my px is minus 3 by x, qx is x cube. Qx last mein use karna hai, but still we are noting it down. So directly you can use this formula for integrating factor, e raised to power integral of this. So that is minus 3 by x dx, e raised to power minus 3 log x, 1 by x cube is the integrating factor. Is it fine? 1 by x cube. Once you get the integrating factor, so the general solution is given by this. Y into integrating factor is equal to the integral of this. So obviously, if formula has already been derived, so we'll be using that directly. So y by x cube is integral of qx into integrating factor. So this becomes just x plus c. So your final general solution is y is equal to x raised to power 4 plus c x cube. So you see how easy it became just by identifying, okay, it is a linear type. Before this, you would have been trying this with exact, or if it turns out to be some other category, but when it is of this form, linear, so it becomes very easy to solve. Right? Okay. Let's do a few more examples. Y dash plus y cot x is 2x cosecant x. Example number 2. So this is directly in the Leibniz form. So my px is cotangent x, qx is whatever is on the right hand side. So integrating factor is e raised to power integral cot x. What is integral of cotangent x? Log sin x. So e raised to power log sin x will make it sin x, because e raised to power log sin x is there. So e and log, so it will be sin x. So that becomes your integrating factor. So your general solution is y into sin x is integral of sin x into 2x cosecant x dx. So 2 is outside, sin x cosecant x balance each other, right? So it's just x dx, x dx. So it is x square by 2 plus c. Your general final answer is x square cosecant x plus c cosecant x, or you can write x square plus c into cosecant x, however you want to write. Right? I think you will be able to do questions of this type once you identify this is linear, so it's easy. Again, I tell you, inspection wale method mein hamesha hume phir bhi rahega, okay, we need to practice whether we click it or not, but when you have a definite formula given to you, so you can always do that. Okay, so let me give you the next type of it. It's related with the same, just a little variation in the type of differential equation. This is called Bernoulli's differential equation. So just like I told you, that type is the Leibniz differential equation, that is a linear first order equation. Let's see how does it look like. So it's of the type dy by dx. Yes, any doubts, class? So we have it in this form. What is the difference? Y raised to power n. I told you that if things become easy when you purely have a function of x on the right hand side, you can always integrate. But this time we just do not have a function of x. We also have function of y, but the thing is, it's a specific function of y. It's not like sine y, cos y. It's always y raised to power something, and that n is integer. That integral power is there, right? Okay, let's not say n is any number. You can also have fractional powers. N is any number. Okay, so if n is 1, if n is 0, then this equation is same as the previous one, because y raised to power 0 will be 1, means there is no y on the right hand side. So if n is going to be 0, this is purely going to be the linear one. Otherwise, this is always going to be non-linear. The presence of y raised to power something, y square, y cube, y raised to power minus 2, y raised to power minus 3, square root of y, something like this. Y ki koi bhi power hai, so it will render the equation into the non-linear category. So we cannot use the linear technique, because this is non-linear one. Now something is there which we can do to make it linear. We can use some substitution method so that it becomes linear. Okay, so this is a particular type of equation for which we can do. Not every non-linear can be converted into linear. Otherwise the world would have been very simple. If every non-linear thing would have been convertible to linear, we would have sorted out many advancements in every field. That's not the case. Non-linear of particular type we can manage. So this is that particular type. You can try to convert this to linear one. So how we are going to do that? You divide with y raised to power n on both the sides. So you will get y raised to power minus n dy by dx. What power you will get here? 1 minus n, right? Because y 1 is already here. You divide with y raised to power n, you get this. And now you get this. So right hand side looks good. It's just a function of x. So now how does your linear looks like? The linear looks like some function of x into y. So yahan pe jo bhi aapka underlying variable hai, your dependent variable, it just has to come in power 1. Only then it will be linear. So we are going to make a substitution for y in another variable such that यहाँ पे जो टर्म है, जो भी वो वेरिएबल होगा उसकी पावर 1 आए, ओनली देन इट इज गोइंग टू बी लीनियर. सो दैट गिव्स अस क्लियर हिंट दैट दिस नंबर, दिस क्वांटिटी वेरिएबल y इज फॉर 1 माइनस n, यू पुट इट सम अदर वेरिएबल v. सो वो अब स्लोली वी आर सॉर्टिंग आउट ऑल द टर्म्स. राइट हैंड साइड सॉर्ट आउट हो गया, अब हम इस टर्म पे आए. इस टर्म को नॉन लीनियर बनाने के लिए डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल की पावर नहीं होनी चाहिए, मींस पावर 1 होनी चाहिए. सो व्हाटएवर यू अज्यूम v इज एट समथिंग, सो y raised to power 1 minus n इज v. सो आई आल्सो नीड टू हैव अ सब्स्टिट्यूशन फॉर dy by dx. सो यू डिफरेंशिएटेड वन टाइम, व्हाट यू विल गेट, यू डिफरेंशिएट दिस, दिस पावर विल बी देयर 1 minus n minus 1 into dy by dx will be equal to dv by dx. Because every time, whenever you are using any substitution of variables method, you also need to find an equivalent substitution for y dash or y double dash, whatever it is. So I got this. So this is clearly y raised to power minus n. Ye 1 1 subtract ho jayega. So it's y raised to power minus n into dy by dx is equal to 1 over 1 minus n dv by dx. And one more thing here, I told you that if n is 0, then it is clearly linear. What if his n is 1? Look carefully, if n is 1. I need a different answer, that's why I'm asking to look at again. It's still linear. वो y ही होगा, उसको आप इस तरह adjust कर सकते हो. When n will be 1, so it will be qx into y, right? And from this side, it is px into y. So in that case, you can write px minus qx into y will be 0. If n is 1, look at the original equation, don't look at the calculation. In the beginning also you make two cases. If n is 0, by default linear. If n is 1, then also this is linear because that y term, because y raised to power 1 is allowed, that can be shifted to left hand side. Okay, this can be 0, but still we have it in the Leibniz form. So why I introduced this one? Because here you are going to have a trouble if n is 1. So that means this thing, whichever we are working for, this is n is non-zero, n is not equal to 1. Because for those two cases, we don't need this technique. It's already linear category. So here, so clearly 1 minus n ka jo factor hai, non-zero hoga because n is not equal to 1. That's why you are adopting this. So I got this substitution. So you make the substitution into the differential equation. What you will get? What you will get for this? 1 over 1 minus n into dv by dx plus px into v is qx. X ke liye koi substitution nahi hai, x ka function x hai, y has been replaced with some function of v. So this 1 minus n, that's just going to be a number that can be adjusted anywhere, right? So this is dv by dx, 1 minus n into px into v is qx. Now this one is the linear type and the Leibniz type. We have expressed this in the same form. And now you can use the technique integrating factor e raised to power. Integral px dx hota hai, वैसे px के साथ ये 1 minus n एक number होगा जो scalar आ जाएगा. अब n will have a particular value for particular questions. Yeah, sorry. Qx के साथ ही है. Just because it's a number, so it's not creating any problem with linearity or non-linearity. Still remaining the equation, making the equation to be linear. So, whenever you identify your equation is a Bernoulli's type, you can directly remember this substitution. There's just one step. You multiply with y for minus n on both the sides and whatever comes here, substitute equals to v. But these steps you have to show. Means if you want to remember this directly, you can remember, but I will suggest that it's better you remember the technique, do these 2-3 steps, and once you get the Leibniz form, it becomes linear. You solve this, and then in the last, again substitute v as your original variable in terms of the original variable y, that will give your final answer. So we'll do questions of the same type next time. That's all for today. If you have any doubts, you can ask.